right, daylight is precious. So I thought I would share a little gem with you that one of you wrote me the other day when I was introducing the Rainbow app. The Rainbow app is now possible to run together with the DJI Mini 2 with the release of the SDK. But one of you pointed out that looking through the Rainbow app, there was actually a hyperlapse function, which is something that rarely is available through these third-party apps. Of course, you can do a hyperlapse. There's no doubt about that. But the Rainbow app can actually do it in-app and stitch every photo together for a final video. And this is what we're going to try out here today. Last time I used the free version, you can use that as well, but just be aware you only have 5 attempts to use these advanced features of the app. So I actually ended deciding buying the app because I didn't want to drive out here next to the highway and end up using all the trials that I had available. If you have seen some of these apps before, it more or less works the same way. So what we can do here right now is we can go under the menu here and I can select the hyperlapse option, and this will allow me to generate a small path that we will have the drone fly. So what we are gonna do here is we're gonna go up here and make sure that we have selected the waypoints. So the first waypoint could be here, the second could be here, then we could have one here, and then we could have one here that is towards the end. Right now, as you can see, if we take a closer look here, you can see that all of the waypoints, they are positioned in 40 meters height, which should be perfectly okay. You can press one of them, then you can adjust it. Waypoint number one is 40, so then let's just put this one to 80. Waypoint number three, we'll put that to 60. Use these tabs here. So now we have 4 waypoints that we will use as a baseline. So now I'm pretty happy with the route. Then I need to decide where drone basically needs to look while it's capturing this hyperlapse. I go up here under this point and then I select the point of interest. And in this case, I think I want the point of interest to be on the freeway, because that will give us some interesting stuff to look at. I can press the point of interest and say what is the altitude. So let's just make sure that it's somewhere up where we can see what's going on. So what you can see now is if you look at those small airplanes around the route here or the path here, you can see all of them are pointing towards the waypoint that we just put on the freeway. Let's see, is there anything else that we can do here? There's a delete button. Clear all. We don't want to do that right now. So now we're ready. Maybe the route here is a little bit too long, so let's just reduce it a little bit here. Just keep your finger on top of the waypoint and then you can drag it to the location where you want, like this. So I think that is nice. Everything is like it's supposed to be. Let's go in here and pull the lock here so we're sure that we are not messing up with anything. And that means that I can't touch anything here. It will not allow me to mess around with the mission, which is probably an advantage once you have locked it. And then I can do this and I can see pre-flight report. Everything is okay. I can see there are 4 waypoints. I need to travel 234 meters. I have a max distance of 86 meters and the time will take us 7 minutes and 59 seconds. Let me just put in a slight disclaimer. There is a slight possibility that you void the warranty of your drone in case that you crash it while using these third-party apps. So just be careful when you're heading out. So if I slide it here, the drone will take off. So now it will start to fly towards waypoint number one. We are a little squeezed on daylight here. Let's just see if we can complete it, but we should have plenty of battery on the drone to be able to complete this. And as you can see, it just tells us here in the bottom how many pictures that we have taken. It might have been unnecessary to start the hyperlapse already now, but just for the sake of this experiment, we're doing this. There are more parameters down here that we could take a look at. We can see that the flight sort of distance that it needs to travel once it reaches waypoint number one is 135 meters. We can see the flight time. We can see what waypoint that it's heading towards. We see right now it's towards number one. We can check that the height is at 40 meters. So hopefully what we will see now is that the drone will start to turn around when it reaches waypoint number one. So now it's turning the camera towards the point of interest that we put on the freeway. So now the actual hyperlapse mission that we planned is being executed. So now we're not touching anything. Let it complete. So what we can see here is that it is increasing in altitude, which we have asked it to do because the waypoint number 2 is at 80 meters height. So hopefully it should be altitude 80 meters when it reaches waypoint 2. So it's already in 80 meters and it's closing in on waypoint number 2. And it's doing a nice soft curve around the corner. And it has so far taken 221 pictures. It took a while for it to change. So now it's doing waypoint number 3 out of 4. So have you tried any of the other third-party apps that is available like Litchi together with your Mini 2? Let me know your experience in the comments below. Oh, so now we passed number 3. The end is nearing. Hopefully not for the drone. So now we are closing in on waypoint number 4. So it'll be interesting to see the final result when it stitches it inside the app. So let's see what it's doing now. So, done. We need to stop it now here. It would have been nice to have a chance to do something else because it's the drone is just hovering in the air right now. I hope. I can see it out there. There's no issues. So now it's building the video of the hyperlapse that we just made. I'm pretty sure, let's check that here afterward, when these missions are planned, that you can actually set a different interval between the images and such. I'd be surprised if that is not possible through the gear wheel out here on the side. Let's see the result here. Woohoo! So now. And it's climbing. And it's going da-da-da-da-da-da, like we have asked it to do. So that's pretty nice. Let's just close it here and then bring the drone back. Just use the lazy approach. Safe back on the ground. Let's just take a look here and see what is possible to set up. Head mode using waypoint headings. To the next waypoint using initial direction controlled by remote using waypoint headings. This is the one that we have been using. So we are pointing the drone towards a point of interest. If I have used point to next waypoint, the camera would simply follow the direction of the next waypoint in line. Using the initial direction, it will simply just keep the direction where you launch the drone. This one controlled by remote controller means that you can adjust the direction of the drone while it's flying its mission. Kind of a headless option. You can set the interval of the images. So it's 1, 2, 3, or 4 seconds, I would assume. Because I can't read it, it's in Chinese. Finish action, we did none. You could make it go home. You could make it auto land, go to first waypoint, or continue to the end. Video clarity, we were doing low. Possible to do high, medium, and low. And I guess this is linked directly to the file size. Either it's a normal mode where it goes directly to the waypoint and then further to the next waypoint where turn will be pretty sharp. We have used the curved approach where it slides very nicely through the curve. How well that worked. That's up for discussion. Gimbal pitch mode, we can focus on the point of interest and there's a possibility to do interpolation. If you select disable, I'm pretty sure that you can set gimbal to a custom angle and it will keep that all the way through all the waypoints. You can set the speed, so you can make it complete the mission much faster than we just did. So this was an introduction to DJI Mini 2 Hyperlapse. How cool is that? We could probably, by playing around with this, optimize the parameters and make a much better result than what I showed here in the video. But this was just an introduction that will fuel your interest of going ahead and doing some really, really nice hyperlapses. And you know what? It's not possible to share those with me on Facebook, but I have 2 other channels available where you can do this. It's either through the Tech Drone Media Facebook group as well as the Tech Drone Media Discord server. In both places, it's possible to communicate with me and the other members of the channel in a much more direct fashion than what you can do below the videos in the comments. I will make sure to link both in the description below. Further, if you're interested in knowing more about the Rainbow app, I tested the tracking capabilities of this app the other day. It was the free version where you have only 5 attempts to test it out. But in case you're interested in that, I'll make sure to link that through this card. If you are more into using Litchi and have used that before, I also tested the tracking capabilities of that as well as the waypoint missions. So in case that you're interested in that, together with your DJI Mini 2, you'll be able to access that through this card. I hope you liked this video. If you did, then feel free to give it a like. If you didn't like it, feel free to press the dislike button twice. Thank you for watching and I'll be seeing you around.